Hello everyone, we are Jessica Cardile
and Sandra Maceta.
Join us as we unravel the insights of Mark Prensky and delve into ideas that are shaping the rapidly evolving digital landscape. So, buckle up for an insightful journey into the mind of a true innovator. A visionary thinker in the field, Mark Prensky introduced the groundbreaking concepts of digital natives and digital immigrants, revolutionizing our understanding of how different generations engage with technology. This American writer and education consultant has been an influential figure in the field of digital education and learning. Currently, he is the founder and CEO of Games to Train, a company focused on learning through play.
He has written extensively on the concept of digital natives and digital immigrants. His most remarkable works are Teaching Digital Natives, Partnering for Real Learning, released in 2010, From Digital Natives to Digital Wisdom, released in 2012, and Empowered, Reframing Growing Up for a New Age, released in 2020, among others. His work has been cited in several publications and has been featured in the New York Times, the Wall Street Journal, and CNN 3.
Digital immigrants are those who were not born into the digital world, but at some point of their lives, become fascinated by and adopted many or most aspects of the new technology, are, and always will be compared to digital natives. Digital natives basically are the new students, those who were born in the net generation or digital generation. They are native speakers of the digital language of computers, video games, and the internet. In the next video posted on YouTube by Prensky, he describes a shift on an old educational paradigm of having kids learn content to a new educational paradigm of having kids solve real-world problems that they care about.
In the past, and even through today, we said, well, if we put kids and content together, the kids will learn and that will make them better kids. And then when they become adults, hopefully, if we're lucky, they will go and improve the world. Now that can change dramatically because we can put kids, starting when they're very young, together with real problems in the world. What are the problems you see in your community, in your family? How can you help those problems? And in doing that, kids come up with solutions, often solutions we didn't think of. They then become people who improve the world while they're students. And the great result is that they become people for the rest of their lives who know they can improve the world, who know how to improve the world, because they've had an education that taught them to do that.
How do digital natives and digital immigrants differ in their digital fluency?
During the pandemic, when we have our virtual classes, the computer I was using decided to restart writing in the middle of the class. At that moment, I was explaining a topic with the help of a book, so I had to connect to my phone and ask one of my students to kindly go into my platform so that he could project. While he shared the screen, I highlighted what was needed and I continue explaining it. All of these are from my phone.
You know the best thing about our friends uploading their selfies? It means I can shotapop them to make them look slightly weird. Oh, wait, no, Sussy looks kind of better there.
Now let's upload them.
Boys! Get away from the computer now! What is wrong with you? I clenched so hard I tore the seat!
I was reading Responsible Parenting magazine.
Responsible Parenting magazine? That's the magazine equivalent of having a live, laugh, love sign hanging over a medieval torture chamber. And what's the scare hoax of the month? Someone found a bazooka in their kid's Halloween candy? Rap music made my nephew eat his own face? Video games played backwards will summon the Prince of Darkness?
No, it's about protecting your children from the dangers of the internet.
Okay, fair enough. I've got nothing sarcastic to say about that.
Good. So when you're online, make sure to leave the spell checker on.
Okay, why?
In case someone tries to hex you with a chain letter.
What?
What are you doing?
Updating your antivirus.
How on earth is that supposed to help, by the way you put it in upside down?
It's like a vaccine. You expose yourself to a little of the virus to build up immunity.
Now what are you doing?
Your keyboard's full of crumbs. Do you want your computer to have bugs? Because that's how you get bugs.
Huh?
Now, I am sorry, but I'm going to have to put the parental lock on.
Okay.
According to Prensky, our students have changed radically. Today, the students are no longer the people our educational system was designed to teach. It was initially designed for a different era, and the students we have today are navigating a significantly changed terrain. It's not merely a change in slang or fashion. We are witnessing fundamental evolution. Some of the most important characteristics of digital natives are: they are used to receiving information really fast. They like to parallel process and multitask. They prefer random access. They function best when networked and thrive on instant gratification and frequent rewards.
It's crucial to regulate our time on electronic devices, since we often spend the whole day like immersed in social media, missing out on more productive activities. I realized that my phone could control my screen time just by a setting with a password. So I asked to my dad to set a password for that setting for me and not tell me the password.
Teachers and institutions need to reconsider methodology and content. They need to learn how to communicate in the language and style of their students.
The concept of digital immigrants, coined by Mark Prensky, describes those who grew up in a time when digital technology was not as pervasive as it is today. Digital immigrants are individuals between 35 and 55 years old who have felt the need to adapt to technology and an increasingly technologized society. The digital immigrant can claim to have participated in two different realities, traditional communication and modern communication. In turn, the actions of immigrants tend to be reflective and therefore slower.
I think it's our turn to inspect your computer.
What do you mean? It works fine.
Mrs. Mom, that pop-up window is 20 years old.
Thank you.
What kind of dark magic forgettery is this? Oh, wait, there is one more problem with this computer. Sometimes it asks me to right-click to do something, but when I do, nothing happens. Can you fix that?
Show me.
Look. Even when I get closer.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Uh-huh. That little donkey just bit the dust.
Alas, yes. But also...
that it's us who need to teach her how to safely use a computer.
On the other hand, future content encompasses the information and skills that are essential in the digital age, because there is a need for educational systems to evolve and incorporate content that aligns with the skills required for success in a technology-driven world, and that are increasingly vital in the modern workforce. Characteristics of future content. In general, there are three characteristics. Number one, involves digital and technological subjects such as software, hardware, robotics, nanotechnology, and genomics. Number two, encompasses ethics, politics, sociology, languages, and other aspects related to the digital age. And number three, aligns with the interests and experiences of today's students, the digital natives. Legacy content refers to traditional pre-digital age information and knowledge, often presented in conventional educational formats. This includes textbooks, lectures, and other traditional learning materials. In general, the characteristics of legacy content are 1. Rooted in traditional subjects like reading, writing, and arithmetic. 2. Emphasizes logical thinking and understanding historical ideas. 3. Represents the traditional curriculum that has been taught for years.
Recently, noticed how difficult it is for my parents to use their phones. And I never realized that they have to do an extra effort every day for simple tasks that can be very normal for people from my generation. So I started taking the time to show them how to do simple things, such as taking pictures, sending the pictures, using different apps, recording videos, sending those videos.
Today's and tomorrow's students do not align with current educational systems and learning processes. If teachers are less knowledgeable about technology than their students, digital natives might be undergoing training in a way that is not suitable for them. In general, they tend to actively participate in constructing their own knowledge. So it is to the teachers to build up these new scenarios in which they learn also how to teach.